Dear 50, 12:39 p.m. It's eviction, dear. Today, Kate and PJ face a public vote. Alex and Jade are the only housemates up.
Everybody is bastard in their own way.
Well, none of us here are. I mean, we're all completely different people. None of us have got friends, really, like everybody in here. Some of us get on better with others. Some of us don't. Some of us pretend we do.
Some of us are liars. Some of us ain't. I'm glad being here, and I'm glad I have got here. But I know I'll never do it again. And you're more aware of things. I ain't gonna start giving people my time. Oh, talking to people. Why am I some sort of mug talking to people and then clearly knowing that person thinks quite. Oh, see you later. I ain't coming back here for no one. Jade, you are a mug. Jade, you think you made friends, but you clearly didn't. Look at the friends you thought you made. Enough, Jade.
One 16 p.m. Only Kate and Jade are up. Alex has gone back to bed.
I wanted to get up after midday, so I'd go quick. Just to get it over and done with. I'm in a big spot last night.
A big spot?
Oh, right, you know this one that I squeezed that went into a scab? Look next to it.
Oh, that looks big.
It looks like it's going to be.
No, hold on, I was looking at the...
Yeah, the scab.
Yeah.
Well, actually, I didn't pick that one, I squeezed it. And do you know how that scabbed over? Because I put Alex's spot cream on it, and it totally just went into a scab.
Because you haven't squeezing before you put the spot cream on.
I know. So basically, it's just dried up. And I was like, please do not come up before tomorrow night.
Six hours till you find out.
Is it about two then?
Wicked.
That suits me. I can have thrown me out of a body, Lolly.
Three 22 p.m. PJ is the only housemate still in bed. Yesterday, the housemates were given a table football game as a reward for cleaning the house.
Yay!
Come on, you've still got a long way to go. How you doing? La 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 la. La 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 la. In your face, in your face, in your face.
When the divide was removed last week, we saw a noticeable increase in the amount of tomfoolery and exhibitionist behaviour in the Big Brother house. With only 2 weeks to go, most of the housemates have started aggressively playing up to the cameras in a sparring pantomime of self-promotion. These loud and obvious attempts to seek attention, the pantomime, are in fact an intensified and delayed backlash against the divide.
One, two, three.
At the start of the game, the housemates viewed the house as a stage where they expected to play the leading roles to win over the audience. This was the game they thought they knew and understood. With the introduction of the divide on week three, suddenly Big Brother became a different game. The bars deprived the housemates of their stage and forced them to show their true colours by changing the emphasis away from their relationship with the public onto their relationships with each other. Some personalities were noticeably affected. For example, Alex's eccentricities came out through humour rather than whingers. Jade almost shared her baby image by becoming more responsible.
Have you tasted gooseberries now? They taste well nice.
The limited space made it hard for them not to be honest in their interactions with each other.
Johnny, do you mind cooking it or do you want me to do
no.
it?
The actors were effectively pushed off the stage and away from their audience for 4 weeks. Now the divider's gone, they're trying to get back to the old rules and make up for lost time by vying for centre stage.
Go, forward.
Right, left.
Tim is the only housemate who's refusing to step onto the stage.
It's a real-life puppet show, in my eyes.
This is because he walked into a divided house, and now he's unable to understand or recognise the new rules. Johnny and Kate are the pantomime directors. Johnny is chief jester. He drives the pantomime behaviour and initiates over 70% of the silly games.
Let's play it. Chase the lasses round the big brother house with your belt when you catch them.
One of his main duties as chief jester is that of house commentator.
This week on Big Brother, Kate and PJ are both up for eviction.
This allows him to deflect the attention onto himself, even when somebody else is centre stage.
Katie's most dark and secret parts of her body touch and caress Alex's bottom.
Kate orchestrates the rest of the games. At the moment, Alex and Jade are content to follow their lead. But games in the Big Brother house are only believable if everybody plays. Thus far, Tim has refused, but the others have joined in. If they stop doing so, Johnny and Kate could end up playing by themselves. This would look like acting. And ultimately, it's been genuine and not artificial that's rewarded in the Big Brother house.
4:35 p.m.
I bet you feel well happy that you've got a week off, haven't you?
Yeah.
5.5 hours to go until the eviction.
Have you got a favourite tonight? Who you think will go? Who you think will go, not who you want.
Do you know what? I really haven't got a clue. I said that to Big Brother. I said, yeah, everyone always knows that when girls have been up against boys, girls normally go, but I gave them reasons why one would stay and one wouldn't go, and it was because we never know, that girls might look at Kate and think, oh yeah, she's funny, strong girl, let's keep her in. Yeah. People might look at PJ and say, oh yeah, we love him, let's keep him in. Yeah. But then people might look at Kate, you know, then they might think, oh, we like the boy, so well, you can't, I don't know.
Bring me back those nights, I need you.
Big Brother calls Jade to the diary room.
What difference will tonight's eviction make to you?
I like to think I was quite close to PJ. We've had differences, a lot of differences. And over the past couple of weeks, I've grown quite close to Kate. And if Kate goes, she's like quite all the time loud, and that's Johnny's playmate. We call them playmates. They're always together, like laughing and playing or doing something. So Johnny will be like, it will be a bit empty without Kate in here, because she is sort of Johnny's playmate and always up for a giggle and would like a fight and things like that. I don't care if she gets marked or hurt. And if PJ was to go, I think he'd also be missed. This is a really weird one, because I think they'll both be missed. And like I said, I know that all three of the boys are really close to PJ. So I have no idea.